My role at Centerstone is a family support specialist. I teach life skills. A lot of my clients struggle with anxiety or depression. Art has been a very beneficial tool, a connection with my clients. I recently started a project with skateboard decks, and the theme was superheroes.
It's supposed to be a kind of a traveling art display for the community. And then, of course, the pandemic hit. Children's mental health began to really, really struggle and still struggling.
Many of them were able to link what they had been through to the superhero that they had chosen, how they themselves have a heroic story to tell.
On my skateboard, mine were all female superheroes because growing up, I never saw any female superheroes other than Wonder Woman. I have a hard time sitting still. I can't focus. I have a lot of issues like that. And I also have anxiety and depression. And so I wanted to show kids, like, women empowering women and a great way to look up and see people that you can identify with. I found a lot of new coping skills, like drawing. I figured out that painting and drawing is one of my really big passions. And these have really gotten me to feel better in some way, since I can let things out in a way that's healthier than what I did before.
I chose Batman, and because I chose him, because he's one of my favorite. Batman is strong, and he fights bad guys.
Rylan, he's really, really smart, so he's got to be occupied. When he's not, his mind is racing, and he'll just go a million miles a minute. But when he's occupied, his teacher said, you know, she went as far as to call him gifted, but if she doesn't occupy his mind, then he's all over the place.
Batman struggles like we do. It's okay to struggle with things.
The biggest struggle of dealing with ADHD during this pandemic, he's so bored. And to try to keep him occupied and, you know, play to his strong suits and just kind of be patient with him and repeat it and try to occupy him as best you can to get the best results, you know.
Look, on the shoes were like, the lines are like all over the place. It's like, when I get crazy, start running around, the shoes represent me.
I've dealt with anxiety ever since the second grade. The skateboard that I did had the Batman logo, the Superman, and the Captain America on it. They're all different and unique in their own ways. I've always did art to, like, express my feelings because it's harder to, like, say it. Even though life gets hard, there's always a way out. You can always try to get through things if you just try.
So I have OCD, and I made my shoes kind of go how I am, like, in order. I have to have my things a certain way, or it bugs me. I would tell other kids about what I've been through. It gets better, and it can change. But there's other ways to cope with it. Like keeping your mind busy with something else, I won't think about it. It helps me. I actually really like art, so I can make it how I want it to be.
I figured out that I had very bad anxiety and depression, I think, in the sixth or fifth grade. I tried to end my life, but I got better because I talked to people. Art kind of, like, expresses yourself without having to say anything to anybody, and you kind of get to figure out what it means, even if they don't really get what it means. Having, like, art and something to do kind of takes your mind off other things going around you. It's a very good distraction. If I were to talk to other kids about what I've been through, I would tell them that not to give up and that you will end up making it.
Centerstone has helped my family in many ways. Like the art, you know, that helps more than anything I've ever seen help.
Art is many forms, is a healthy and much needed outlet to allow our children to have a voice.
It's such a creativity, and they can take pride in it, and they escape from the problems when they're involved.
That validation is so important in their journey and towards healing.
I would say focus on the love you have for your child first, because through that you can do about anything. Then good things will happen.
I have a statement made by one of my teens. I want others to see they are strong even when they think they are not. Anxiety and depression can feel like they are weighing me down and pulling me apart. I hope other people who see the project will be able to understand that they aren't weird or broken, and that others have the same feelings and understand, and that be open and talking about it is a lot better than keeping it inside.